So what are we gonna do about our anniversary?
I don't know.
This year, Amber and I will be married 20 years. From the first year all the way up to the 10th year, we have never celebrated our anniversary. On our 10th year anniversary, we went out to like a Japanese steakhouse. And then we were back home in like an hour and a half.
Over the last 20 years, there's been many years that we don't have extra money to spend on anniversary celebrations. And then it's become kind of, even if we do have money to spend, I can find other ways to spend that money.
I really would like to do something.
What do you want to do?
I don't know, go somewhere.
It's a big milestone, don't get me wrong.
We can go out to a fancy hotel, eat a fancy dinner, buy some fancy lingerie, and come back home the next morning.
We don't need to buy no fancy lingerie, because why am I going to spend money on something that's going to end up on the floor?
Amen to that, sister.
We could actually go do one of our, like, very first date spots. I lived in North Carolina. Trent lived in Georgia. One of our first dates was going to Atlanta, and Trent took me to various, like, tour spots, and one of the tour spots was the Sundial Restaurant. It was very fancy, and obviously we didn't have any money, so we split a dessert.
It's true love when you don't have enough money to park, so you have to, like, park on the streets for a real short period of time, and then run upstairs and just wine her and dine her with some, like, shared ice cream.
No, it was cheesecake.
Cheesecake. And then run back downstairs hoping that your car didn't get towed away.
It didn't bother me then. It doesn't bother me now. Can you believe 20 years?
No, that was like,
and everybody
25.
Said we wouldn't make it. I'm ready to go to bed.
That sounds like a plan. I love you.
Remember when Nana came downstairs that time?
Yes.
But we were just sitting on top of the bed.
We weren't
doing anything. Nana come down on like a mean gorilla. She ain't ever gone down her steps that fast. It's a pretty place. Amber and I are at the Peach House in Atlanta, Georgia. We're celebrating our 20th wedding anniversary. This is a weekend of mom and dad, Trent and Amber, TNA, whatever we want to be this weekend. That's who we're going to be, and we're all by ourselves. And that's the most important thing.
Oh, that's one of those camera things.
Well, that camera's definitely not getting us. Hi.
Hi.
How are
so you?
You
must be Trent and Amber.
Yes.
Amber,
nice to meet
nice
you.
To
you're
you.
Miss Beverly.
Trent, I am.
Okay.
So let's come on up. You've got the best room in the house. We tried to make it very special since it is your anniversary.
Fantastic.
Thank you.
So we,
nice.
And
thank you so much.
You're welcome. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And we'll have
yes.
some champagne for you later tonight. And we're going to have dinner downstairs in just a little while. Yeah, I'll see you guys downstairs.
All right, thank
you
again.
Okay,
thank
you. Bye.
Bye.
Did you see the little people furniture?
Oh, I did. It was not like doll furniture, you know, but it was literally miniature Victorian sofa
and chair. I don't think it was little people furniture. I think this is more like Tom Thumb furniture. I mean, it's tiny.
Your butt could not fit in that.
No.
No.
Here, you sit in that and I'll take your pictures. The chair, it didn't fit.
It wasn't made for these size asses.
No. This is an Akon butt right here, and it doesn't fit.
The butt could fit on this one.
You like you're scared to death. You gotta have fun with it.
Yes, it just creaks. The sofa fit our butt, but I mean, literally, we look like giants.
So you gotta be like this.
Yeah, and this is what I'm texting to our kids.
First time I've ever felt like a giant on a sofa.
Yeah, but I did. I felt like I was gonna break it.
It's not many times I can sit on the sofa and my feet hit the floor.
You gonna pull up and park a little bit?
Okay.
It's been a long time since me and Miss Amber have been parking. I figured we're in Atlanta. The kids aren't around us. Under the streetlights, you know.
Looking at the skyline.
I mean, how much more romantic can we be? It's a totally different world.
We're not city folks.
No, we're not country bumpkins either, but we're suburbians. 20 years ago, when we were standing up there getting married, Did you think we would be celebrating 20 years later, 5 kids?
I didn't know like the exact number and all that kind of stuff, but I knew we would definitely have kids and we would make it in life, for sure. You're just standing out in the space.
I like looking at all these buildings and these lights.
After our wedding and after the reception, we took off to Atlanta for the night and we stayed in a very nice hotel. We were able to swing the honeymoon suite. We checked in and went up to our room and we were exhausted. So we basically undressed and watched a little bit of TV. And then
we get
a knock on the door, knock, 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 knock. So, you know, I'm like, what the heck? And then I realized 2 weeks before our wedding, 2 men were murdered execution style in the same hotel.
So that immediately started going through our mind.
Yeah, and we're like, oh God, he's back. The door opens. And when the door opens, we have the chain locked. And someone is sticking their hand through our hotel door. So I took about 4 steps back and I ran towards the door. And right when I got to the door, I just jumped and I kicked it as hard as I could. And I smashed their whole hand right here all the way across their knuckles and their fingers.
They didn't get us and they didn't try to come back in.
They weren't happy. So we called down to the front desk of the hotel and they told us that it was a young man that had come to the door to turn down our bed as part of the honeymoon package. That he was,
it's like it was housekeeping,
bringing us some chocolate strawberries.
The problem was is none of that was told to us when we checked in.
So what happened to his hand?
My daddy told me a long time ago, only ask the questions that are important. Don't volunteer any information.
Oh, those were the days.
Yeah.
Good times, babe. I love you.
I love you.